Yes, Deepika.
Yes, sir. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to another session of Thursday Thoughts hosted by KVC Academy. We are delighted to have you present here. And today's session is going to be extremely special, for three reasons. That today's session is for the students of KVC as well as of the parents of KVC. Today's session is special because we not only have one person addressing you, we have four amazing personalities addressing you. And today's session is also special because it is for you. I am so happy to introduce to you our speakers for the day. We have with us CA Bhargava Tantri, we have with us CA Shivananda Pai, and we have with us CA Giridhar Kamath, who are chartered accountants for fairly long periods of time, more than even my age right now, and who have got children who are pursuing this field or have already completed their course in CA. So it is not only important for students to study, it is also important for parents as much as it is for students, because they play a very important role in the lives of students when they are studying for their CA. And I am sure the four of them present here today, along with our very own master CA Kiran Vasan, are going to enlighten the students as well as the parents of the students on the do's, don'ts, and their respective journeys. So let's hope to have a great session among the four amazing personalities here today. So enjoy, and please feel free to ask any doubts that you have towards the end of the session. You can put it on the chat box or you can message us personally, and we'll be happy to address y'all. Thank you very much. Over to you, Kiran sir.
Thank you, Deepika.
Anytime.
I hope I am audible.
Yeah.
And visible.
Open mode.
A very good evening to all of you. This is a special program for me, from my heart, because over 30 years of my teaching experience, I have always encountered students with issues. There have been students who have come to us with various sorts of problems, and every problem is different. But along with the students, we also have to deal with parents. We have to deal with parents also. Now, for me personally, when a parent has an issue, it hurts more. A student's problem can be solved in no time, maybe sometimes in a day, sometimes in a week, sometimes over a period of months. But the parent's problem would be more genuine and more burdensome. And therefore, I thought, why not have a kind of a podium where we could bring in all these people together, one platform where we could bring in the students and parents and then narrate our experience. And it suddenly struck me, why not share the experience of three of my great friends who are, coincidentally, we are all past chairmen of the Mangalore branch of ICAI, all the four of us. Okay? All the four of us have children who are into the course. I mean, of course, Malu, Giridhar Kamath's daughter Malvika, has already become a chartered accountant. We can't just forget her marriage. It just seems yesterday, one of the best marriages in town that I've seen. And also Shivanand sir and Bhargav sir have handsome boys who are doing CA. My son also is going to run his finals in the COVID attempt of August. I call it the COVID attempt. So we have some experiences in dealing with our children. I have some experience in dealing with parents and students. So we would like to share this. So the idea would be, first, I will ask these learned gentlemen to talk to you all. And then afterwards, kindly shoot questions. Ivattina karyakrama kannadallu jaragabahudu, maatadabahudu. Idu bhashe mukhyavalla. Tilivike mukhya. ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ದಷ್ಟು ಕನ್ನಡ ಇಷ್ಟೇ ಬಟ್ ಮೈ ಫೆಲೋ ಪ್ಯಾನಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆರ್ ಮಾಸ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ಆರ್ ಕೊಂಕಣಿ ಆರ್ ತುಳು ಎನಿ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಐ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಲಿಸನ್ ಸಿನ್ಸಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಡಿಡ್ಲಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಅಸ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ದಿ ಇಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಒನ್ ಅನದರ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಮೈ ಸೈಡ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಆನ್ ವೆನ್ ಐ ಸಮ್ ಅಪ್ ದ ಸೆಷನ್ ಬಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ನೌ ಐ ವುಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ಇನ್ವೈಟ್ ದ ಸೀನಿಯರ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಅಮಂಗ್ ಅಸ್ ಸಿ ಎ ಗಿರಿಧರ್ ಕಾಮತ್ to kindly address. You'll have to unmute yourself. Okay,
this is a very, very typical program that Kiran has planned for the benefit of students and especially for the parents who are, whose children are pursuing CA course. So, ಇದರಿಂದ ಆಗುವ ಒಂದು ಸಮಾನ ಮನಸ್ಕರ್ವ ಮತ್ತು ಸಮಾನ ದುಃಖಿಗಳು ಅಥವಾ ಸಮಾನ ಸುಖಿಗಳು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಒಟ್ಟಾಗಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ನಾವು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ನಾನು ಇನ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಈ ಒಂದು ರಸ್ತೆಯನ್ನು ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಹಲವರು ಈ ರಸ್ತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಉಂಟು, ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಇವತ್ತಲ್ಲ ನಾಳೆ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಹೀಗಿರುವಾಗ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತನಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನನಗೆ ಹೇಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಕಿರಣ್ಗೆ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಸಿ ಎ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಷ್ಟು ಮುಳುಗಿದೇವಯ್ಯ, ಸಿ ಎ ಮತ್ತು ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮತ್ತು ಪ್ರತಿದಿನ ಪ್ರತಿ ವರ್ಷವೂ ಹೊಸ ಹೊಸ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಮುಳುಗಿದ್ದೇವೆಯೋ. ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ ಅವರ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಒಳ್ಳೇದಾಗುದಂತಾದ್ರೆ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ರೆಡಿ ಟು ಗೋ ಎ ಮೈಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ಟು ಡೂ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ಕನ್ಸಿವಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬ್ರಿಂಗಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್. ಕಿರಣ್, ಈಗ ಸಿ ಎ ಎಂಬ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಸಹ ಮನನ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಇದು ಕಷ್ಟ ಹೌದು, ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಉಂಟಾ? ಖಂಡಿತ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಉಂಟು. ನಾನು ನನ್ನ ಮಗಳ ವಿಷಯ ಮಾತಾಡೋಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮೊದಲು ನನ್ನದೇ ವಿಷಯ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೇನೆ. ನಾನು ಬಿ ಕಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎವರೇಜ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್, ನನಗೆ ಬಿ ಕಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 56-58% ಏನೋ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿತ್ತು. ಮತ್ತೆ ಸಿ ಎ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂತ ನಾನು ಯಾಕೆ ಹೋದ್ರೆ, ನಂಗೆ ಸಿ ಎ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕೆಂಬ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಷನಲ್ ಇಚ್ಛೆಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗಿ ಸಿ ಎಗೆ ಹೋದ್ರೆ, ಸಿ ಎ ಆದ್ರೆ ದೇಶಾದ್ಯಂತ ಸುತ್ತುವ ಒಂದು ಚಾನ್ಸ್ ಸಿಗ್ತದೆ, ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದಂತ ನಂಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿತ್ತು. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನನ್ನ ತಂದೆ ಒಂದು ಕಂಪನಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜರ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರು. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆಡಿಟಿಗೆ ಬರುವಾಗ ನಾನು ಕೆಲಸ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗುವಾಗ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆಡಿಟಿಗೆ ಬಂದವರು ನಂಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ರು, ನಾನು ಮೊನ್ನೆ ಡೆಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೆ, ನಾನು ಮೊನ್ನೆ ಯುಪಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೆ, ಹಾಗೆ ಅಂತ. ಆಗ ನಂಗೆ ಮನದಟ್ಟಾಯ್ತು, ಸಿ ಎ ಆದ್ರೆ ತಿರುಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಖಂಡಿತ ಸಿಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ. ನಂಗೆ ಒಂದು ತಿರುಗುವ ಹುಚ್ಚು ಆಗದಿಂದಲೂ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿತ್ತು, ಆದ್ರಿಂದ ನಾನು ಸಿ ಎಗೆ ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆದದ್ದು. ಸೊ ಇವತ್ತಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಖಂಡಿತವಾಗಿ ಖುಷಿಯಾಗಿದ್ದೇನೆ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ತಿರುಗುವ ಹುಚ್ಚಿನಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬಾ ತಿರುಗಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ಬಟ್ ಸಿ ಎ ನಾನು ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆದಾಗ ಇವತ್ತಿನ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟಿ ಅವತ್ತು ನಮಗೆ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಹೀಗೆ ಕಿರಣ್ ಆಗಿ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸ್ಡ್ ವೇಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕೋಚಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟಿ ಮಂಗಳೂರಲ್ಲಿ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ನಾವು ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಚೆನ್ನೈಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕಿತ್ತು ಆ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ, ಮತ್ತು ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಸಹ ತುಂಬಾ ಆಗ್ತಿತ್ತು, ಆಗ ಅದನ್ನು ಎಫರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಹ ಆಗ್ತಿರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಅಂತಹ ಒಬ್ಬ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್, ಮತ್ತು ಆಗ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಒಂದು ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇತ್ತು ಇಂಟರ್ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಇದು ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ನಾನು ಕಲ್ತದ್ದು ಕನ್ನಡ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 1-10 ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ವರೆಗೆ. ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ತಗೊಂಡೋಗೋದು ಕಾಮರ್ಸ್. ಕಾಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಆಗ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಈ ಒಂದು ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್, ಈ ಒಂದು ಪೇಪರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 100 ಮಾರ್ಕಿನ ಪೇಪರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 50 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್, 50 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್. ಈ 50 ಮಾರ್ಕಿನ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಗಾಗಿ ನಾವು 2 ವರ್ಷದ ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿಯ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕಲಿಬೇಕಿತ್ತು. ನಾನು ಸಾಧಾರಣ ಒಂದು 7-8 ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಥ್ಸ್ ಕಲಿಯದೆ ನಾನು ಸ್ಟಾಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 40 ತಗೊಂಡು ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗ್ತೇನೆ ಅಂತ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿದೆ, ಆದ್ರೆ ಆಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದರ ನಂತರ ನಾನು ಆ ನಮೂನೆ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕಲಿತು ಆ ಒಂದು ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಪಾಸ್ ಆದ ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಂಗೆ ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 30+ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿತ್ತು, ಸ್ಟಾಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 40+ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿತ್ತು. ಸೊ ಇದರಿಂದ ನಾನು ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಯ್ತು. ಸೊ ನಾನು ಇದು ಯಾಕೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಸಿ ಎ ಎಂಬುದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಛಲವನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಕೋರ್ಸ್. ಈ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಈ ನಿಮ್ಮನೆಯ ಛಲ ಹಿಡಿದು ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಈ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಸಾಧ್ಯತೆ ಇದೆ. ಇಷ್ಟು ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಸಹ ಫೇಲ್ ಆಗುವವರು ಇದ್ದಾರಾ? ಖಂಡಿತ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ 100 ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೇನೆ. ಅಷ್ಟು ಓದಿ ಅಷ್ಟು ಬ್ರಿಲಿಯಂಟ್ ಇದ್ದು ಸಹ ಫೇಲ್ ಆದವರು, ಆದ್ರೂ ಇದೇನು ಮಾಡದೆ ಬಿಕಾಮಿಗೆ ಹೋದಾಗೆ 1 ವಾರ ಓದಿ ಪಾಸ್ ಆದವರು ಯಾರು ಸಹ ಸಿ ಎ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ನೀವು ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಫರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಕು, ಆದಾಗ ಮಾತ್ರ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ಸಿಗ್ತದೆ. ಈಗ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ನ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತನಾಡುವ, ನಾನು ಆಸ್ ಎ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ ನನ್ನ ಮಗಳು ಓದುವಾಗ ನನ್ಗೆ 2 ಮಕ್ಕಳು, ಒಬ್ಳು ಈಗ ಸಿ ಎ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾಳೆ, ಇನ್ನು 2ನೇ ಅವಳು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾಳೆ. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಮೇಲೆ ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಹಾಕ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ, ನೀನು ಸಿ ಎ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು, ನೀನು ಇದಾಗ್ಬೇಕಾದಂತ ನಾನು ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಸಹ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಹೇಳಲಿಲ್ಲ. 2ನೇ ಮಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಈಗ ಅವಳು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾಳೆ. ನನ್ನ ಹೆಂಡತಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್, ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಇನ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಕಾಲೇಜಸ್, ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ಎನ್ ಅನೆಸ್ಥೆಶಿಯಾಲಜಿಸ್ಟ್. ಆದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಮಗಳು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಅವಳು ಸಹ ಹೇಳಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಮಗಳು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ನ, ಓಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ವು. ಸೊ ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳುವ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ, ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯ ಒಂದು ನಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವುದು ಆಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನು ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೇರುವ ಅಥವಾ ನಮ್ಗೇನು ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಉಂಟು ಅದನ್ನು ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೇರುವ ಒಂದು ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಟ್. ನನ್ನ ಇಬ್ಬರು ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ನಾನು 1ನೇ ಇಂದ 5ನೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ನವರೆಗೆ ಕನ್ನಡ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ ಶಾಲೆಗೆ ಕಲಿಸಿದ್ದು, ಅದರ ನಂತರ 6th ಅವರನ್ನು ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಂಗೆ ಕಲಿಸಿದ್ದು. ಆದ್ರಿಂದ ನೀವು ಭಾಷೆ ಅಥವಾ ಕಲಿತ ಶಾಲೆ ಇದು ಯಾವುದು ಕೂಡ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬಾ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುವ ಅವರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಒಬ್ಬ ಅಲ್ಲ. ನನ್ನ ಮಗಳು ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಲ್ವಿಕಾ ಅಂತ ಅವಳ ಹೆಸರು. ಅವಳು ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇದು ಕಾಮನ್ ಪ್ರೊಫಿಷಿಯನ್ಸಿ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಅದರ ನಂತರ ಐ ಪಿ ಸಿ ಸಿ ಬೋತ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅದನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾಸ್ ಆದ್ದು. ಅದರ ನಂತರ ಫೈನಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಶಿ ಟುಕ್ 2 ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫೈನಲ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳುವಾಗ ಅವಳು ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ಹೋಗುವಾಗ ಒಂದು ದೇವರ ಹತ್ರ ಬೇಡದಿತ್ತು, ನನಗೆ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಕೊಡು ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗುವಂತ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಕೊಡು ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಅದು ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಫೇಲ್ ಆದ ನಂತರ 2ನೇ ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗುವಾಗ ದೇವರಲ್ಲಿ ಇವಳು ಬೇಡಲಿ ಶುರು ಆಡಿತು, ಎಲ್ಲ ನಿನ್ನಾಗೆ ನಿಂಗೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೇನೆ, ನಂಗೆ ನೀನು ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡಲೇಬೇಕು ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಇದು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಬರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ, ಅಷ್ಟು ಕಾನ್ಫಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಬರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಎಫರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಕು. ಈಗ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ for the parents to you have to understand that it is a challenge. It is a challenge. CA is definitely a challenge because these days for your information, I'm part of an organization which goes to various colleges, government colleges, picks students from there, brings them to Bangalore, and we train them for 3 days for on employability, 3 days or 1 week or 18 days depending on that, and all this is free. This is sponsored by someone. So all this is free, and looking at the students, I feel we in Mangalore are all blessed lot. So there are colleges where there is not enough facility to sit. There are students who go to the college, copy whatever their homework is given. So compared to all that, we are blessed. We in Mangalore and surrounding Mangalore, we have good education facilities. We are blessed. So count your blessings. Now coming to the parents, now do's and do's here, don'ts here, like it depends on individual cases, but still I can sum up certain do's what you have to do. First and foremost is you have to see to it that your son or daughter avarige swa ichche irbeku. It is on their own that they have taken up the course. They are not forced to take up this course. Avara swa ichche inda ee course annu tekondre matra idralli mundavarilike aagtade. Any other course you take, it may be MBBS, it may be engineering, it may be any other course, you can impose on them and you can see to it that they get passed. But this particular course, it is impossible because we have the example of many CAs whose children are pursuing this, and we know how difficult it is. Now coming to next one, so before they take up the course, ask them to visit some CA's office. Talk to some chartered accountants, see the surroundings. If they are in two minds, nange MBA agbeku athava nange CA agbeku anta iddre antavaranu neevu CA ge korisuvaga yavadaru CA office ge ond 3-4 CA office ge hoglikke heli alli maatadlikke heli. Mattu third one is patience. You should have lot of patience. So parents should have lot of patience because unless this is not like any other course, okay, you cannot dictate terms here. This is not like any other course. It all depends on what you do or what your son or daughter does on that particular day in the examination hall in those 3 hours. It all depends on that. So incidentally, today is India's World Cup 1983 Kapil Dev's day on 25th of June 1983. We won World Cup. So you know how Kapil Dev came up suddenly and scored and became a overnight he became a master. So similarly, as you practice, as you go on, one day your child becomes a master in what he is doing, and that is the time when he will thank the world that it has helped him to come to that extent. Till that time, he has to be handled very carefully. He is very fragile. He or she is very fragile. He or she has to be handled very very carefully because he or she is doing such a course which is a great challenge, and you have to give your 110% in that. So then do you have 2-3 minutes more, Kiran? Yeah. Next. Okay, then you may some of the parents whose child has not passed one or has given 2-3 attempts, you may think that it is waste of time. So take it from me, I can give it to you in writing. 3 years articleship, which he or she completes in any office, is going to empower him enough so that he can beat any of his contemporaries in any other college and come up in life. So don't worry about that. And don't worry about any future plans. So once he becomes CA, I'll set up office for him here, or he will go to multinational or any other things. Don't worry about that. Because people like me, people like Kiran, we have never dreamt that we will one day sit like this and talk to you over this webinar. So I did my articleship in a small office in Udupi. Then I was in the same office, in head office. I was brought to Mangalore and I stayed back in Mangalore. And today I am one of the partners in the firm. So I am not related to the erstwhile partners or the forming partners. So now have faith in your child. Have faith in your child. Talk to them whenever they have mood. Nimge mood untanta avaratra hogi hage martta idde enta martta idde avarige mood illadidre enu maatadodalla avaranna avarashtake bidi. Kelavu sala avarige mood irthade, and when they are in mood they will come to you. Then as if nimge bere aga mobile annella badigidi TV annu off maadi full 100% avarige concentration kottu avaru helidakkella ha ha heli mattu madhyadalli ond erdu prashnegalannu avarige haaki. So you have to give them 100% concentration when they want to talk to you. So listen to them 100%. Then don'ts helidadre na avaratra ondu matra puna puna helbedi. Naavu nimma prayadalli iruvaga eshtu kashta itto gotunta nanu office inda manege madhyana cycle alli bartidde idellavannu omme illadru common aagi ಜನರಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಿಬಿಡಿ, ಅವರಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ಬೇಕು ಎಷ್ಟು ಕಷ್ಟ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂತ. ಬಟ್ ಪುನಃ ಪುನಃ ಇದನ್ನು ಅವರ ಮಂಡೆಗೆ ಹಾಕ್ಬೇಡಿ, ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಅವರು ನಾವು ಆಗ ಇರುವ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಮತ್ತು ಅವರು ಈಗ ಇರುವ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಈಸ್ ಟೋಟ್ಲಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್. ಇವತ್ತು ನಾನು ನಿಜವಾಗಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಇವತ್ತಿನ ದಿನದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು CA ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಅಷ್ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಉಂಟು. ಸೊ ಐ ಕಂಗ್ರ್ಯಾಚುಲೇಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ದೆಮ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಗಟ್ಸ್ ಟು do this course, come to this course in spite of all those distractions. So whether you call it social media, whether you call it mobile, anything, there is so much of distractions which happily we did not have, thank God. So don't talk about results, never talk to them about results. Yaradu nimge socially ellaru devasthanadalli ellaru sikkidre sa result CA result na bagge kelbedi. Okay, ಮೂರನೇದಾಗಿ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಟಾಕ್ ಟು ದೆಮ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ಸ್, ಡೋಂಟ್ ಟೆಲ್ ದೆಮ್. ದೆನ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್, ಅವ ನೋಡು ರಾತ್ರಿ ಹಗಲು ಓದ್ತಾರಂತೆ, ಅವ ನೋಡು ಬೋತ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಒಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಪಾಸ್ ಆದಂತೆ. ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಸಹ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಟಾಕ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್, ನೆವರ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ದೆಮ್ ವಿತ್ ಅದರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನೋ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ವಾಂಟ್, ದೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನೋ ವೇರ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗೋ, ದೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ನೋ ಹೌ ಟು ಗೋ ದೇರ್. So we just have to be by their side so that whenever required they can lean on us. So this should be the concept and this should be the way in which we have to handle. Thank you, Kiran. Yeah.
Thank you, Giri sir. That was I think a very nice message that you have given us, but I'm sure even Bhargav and Shiv have got more to share with us. So first I will ask Bhargav sir, could you please tell us something about your experience and what you have message for the parents?
Good evening, everybody. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Good evening.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. First, I would like to thank Kiran and the whole team for bringing in this new idea of having an interaction with the parents of the student, which is much needed in these days because a lot of tension is there everywhere because of the COVID pandemic and other things, and everybody will be worrying what is going to happen. All the exams are being postponed, all the including the SLC. Today there was a news that even CBSE exam, the Supreme Court has said that it should not be done. All those things are happening, and even the CA exams are also in a limbo. They have postponed it to July 31st, but don't know whether it will be conducted or not. So in this time it is better to have such type of program. So first let me introduce myself. As ಇವರು ಗಿರಿಧರ್ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗೆ ನಾನು ಅದೇ ದಾರಿಯಲ್ಲೇ ಹೋಗ್ತೇನೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ಗಿರಿಧರನ್ನು ನಾವು ಒಂದು ರೀತಿಯ ಗುರುಗಳಾಗೆ ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ, ಅವರ ಅದೇ ದಾರಿಯಲ್ಲೇ ನಾನು ಹೋಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಇಚ್ಛೆ ಪಡ್ತೇನೆ. ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳಿದಾಗೆ ನಾವೇನು ಸಿ ಎ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿಕೊಂಡು ಒಂದು ಛಲ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಬಂದಿದ್ದಲ್ಲ. ನನ್ನ ತಂದೆ ಒಬ್ರು ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರು, ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು ನೀನು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಥವಾ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರು ಆರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಸಚ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಯು ವಾಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್. ಬಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲಿನೇಷನ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಸಿ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಸೆಡ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ಸಿ ಎ. ಹಿ ಸೆಡ್ ಓಕೆ ಯು ಗೋ ಅಹೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಸೈಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಮೀ. I was a science, I am a science graduate. I did my BSc and then jumped into this commerce field. Because of his contacts, I had to, because as Giri said, during our time, there were no coaching classes or no, even giving tuition to a student was considered as a taboo from the lecturer's point of view at that time. So I had to beg with some lecturers and to coach me in, what do you call that, commerce subjects. So somehow I did. And my advantage was I had maths and stats strong, unlike commerce students. We had 50 marks, so that I could clear easily. Then I did my CA, then I nanig Mangalore alli practice martta idene since almost last 30 years. My wife is also, she has completed her articles and intermediate and final attempt, she couldn't make it because by that time my son was there. So ಮಗನಿಂದಾಗಿ ಅಮ್ಮ ಸಿ ಎ ಮಾಡೋದನ್ನ ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸಿದ್ಲು, ಮಗ ಅದನ್ನು ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೊರಟಿಲ್ಲ. ನೀವಲ್ಲ, ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೈನ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಎ ಚಾರ್ಟರ್ಡ್ ಅಕೌಂಟೆಂಟ್, ವಿ ನೆವರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಹಿಮ್. ಅವನು ಸಾಧಾರಣ ಸಣ್ಣದಿರುವಾಗ ನನ್ಗೆ ಈಗಲೂ ನೆನಪಿದೆ, ಅವನು 5ನೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೋ ಇರುವಾಗ ನಾವು ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಹೀಗೆ ಡೈನಿಂಗ್ ಟೇಬಲಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಿರುವಾಗ ನೀನೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀಯಪ್ಪ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ವಿ. ಅವನು ನನ್ನನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸಿ ನಿನ್ನ ಆಫೀಸಿಗೆ ಬರ್ತೇನೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ. ಆಗ ಅವನಿಗ ನನ್ನ ಇದ್ರ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಅವನಿಗಾಗ ಅದು ನನ್ನ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತುಂಟಾ ಇಲ್ವೋ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಆದ್ವಿ. ಪುನಃ ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸಮಯದ ನಂತರ ದೆನ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಹಿಮ್, ಹಿ ಸೆಡ್ ಯಾ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಸಿ ಎ. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಕನ್ವಿನ್ಸ್ ಹಿಮ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಎ ಸಿ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ಮೈ ವೈಫ್ ಶಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಗೋನ್ ದಟ್ ಸಿ ಎ, ಯು ನೀಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಅದರ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಇಟ್. ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಟಬ್ಬರ್ನ್ ಆನ್ ದಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಎಫರ್ಟ್. ದೆನ್ ವೆನ್ ಹಿ ಬಿಕೇಮ್ to the high school, when he was in the 9th standard, we finally asked him. He said, yeah, I'm going to do CA. So then we started giving him all the other facilities which is available, getting him the materials and other things, because we were in an advantageous position because we both have done our CA. Samskritadalli ondu heltare, lalayet panchavarshani dashavarshani taadayet praapteshu shodashe varshe putram mitra ವಾಚಯೇತ್ ಅಂತ. ಅಂದರೆ 5 ವರ್ಷದವರೆಗೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಮುದ್ದು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಂತೆ. 5 ವರ್ಷದಿಂದ 10ನೇ ವರ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಬರುವಾಗ ಅವರನ್ನು ಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಬೆಳೆಸಬೇಕು, ಅದನ್ನು ತಾಡಯೇತ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ ನಾವು. ಅವರ ಮೇಲೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟಾಗಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅವರಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬುದ್ಧಿಯನ್ನು ಕಲಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಇದು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಅವನು 16 ವರ್ಷ ಷೋಡಶ 16 ವರ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದ ನಂತರ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಇಮ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಅವನು ಅಂದರೆ ಸಾಧಾರಣ 16 ವರ್ಷ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ಅವನು 10ನೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಗೆ ಬಂದಿರ್ತಾನೆ. ಅದರ ನಂತರ ಹಿ ಬಿಕಮ್ a young boy. So other than that, we should treat him as a friend. So now adanne martta idve avanadu yava ritiya samasyegalu idre sa adakke naavu samadhananu helta idve, shiva neenu hage maadbeda hige maadbeda anta avanige helta irlilla. We never used to scold him once he crossed the 10th standard. We were guiding him, that is what is required. And since we are in the same field, we know what are the difficulties, how to go about and other things. But to the other parents who are sitting here, they may not be in the same position. My suggestions for them is avrige yav rithiya stress kodlikke hogbedi, avaru eshtu ottara ashtu odli. CA alli odidre matra pass aagudu, bere yav rithiyalli pass aaglik sadhya illa. Giridhar sir helta idru devaranna ka prarthane maadbeku anta. Devaranna prarthane maadidre namge manasige ondu dhairya bartade ashte, but devaru namanna pass maadodilla, namanna naave pass maadkolbeku. So devara mele nambike idi, nimma mele nambike idi, neevu adanna pass maadlikke aagtade anta ondu neevu munde sare nimge khandita pass aaglik. Parents sa hage, ಇದು ಬೇರೆ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ನ ಹಾಗೆ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಬೇರೆ ಯಾವುದೋ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಕೋಚಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಲ್ಲಿ ಕೋಚಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಕೋಚಿಂಗ್ ಇರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಈಗ ಕೆಲವು ಕೋಚಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಂಟರ್ಸ್ ಬಂದಿದೆ, ನಮ್ಮ KVC ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿ ಅಂತ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಬಂದಿದೆ, ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಹೇಳಿಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಬಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೂಮ್ನ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೂಮ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೋಚಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಡುವಂಥ ಇದು ನಮ್ಮ ಈ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಇದು ಹೇಗಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ, ನಾವು ಸ್ವತಃ ಕಲಿತು ಅದನ್ನ ಅರಗಿಸಿಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಪರೀಕ್ಷೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬರಬೇಕು. ಇದು ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಓರಿಯೆಂಟೆಡ್ ಅಪ್ರೋಚ್ ಇದು. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಒತ್ತು ಕೊಟ್ಟುಕೊಂಡು ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಕಲಿತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನೀವು ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅವರ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಹಾಕಬೇಡಿ. ಈಗ ಆ ಅದೇ ಹುಡುಗನ ಅಥವಾ ಹುಡುಗಿಯ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅವನು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗು ಅಥವಾ ಬೇರೆ ಯಾವುದೋ ಕೋರ್ಸಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಅವನು ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗದೇ ಇರ್ಬೋದು. ಅಂತ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ಅವನಿಗೆ ನೀವು ಆದಷ್ಟು ಧೈರ್ಯ ತುಂಬಿ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಸಿ ಎ ಕಲಿತಾ ಇರೋ ನಾವು ಎಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸಿ ಎ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಮ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಅಂತ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮೇ ನವೆಂಬರ್ ಎರಡು ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಪ್ರತಿ ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫೇಲ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ನವೆಂಬರ್ ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಮ್ ಅಗೇನ್, ನವೆಂಬರ್ ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫೇಲ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಮೇ ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಮ್ ಅಗೇನ್. ಈ ರೀತಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಆ ರೀತಿ ತಗೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಪಾಸ್ ಆದವರು. ಸೊ ಆ ರೀತಿಯ ಒಂದು ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಅನ್ನ ನೀವು ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅವರು ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯ ನಿಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾದರೂ ಒಂದು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆಗಳಿದ್ರೆ, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲದಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋರ ಹತ್ರ ಅವರನ್ನು ಕಳಿಸಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿಕೊಡಿ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನನಗೆ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ನನ್ನ ತಂದೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು. ಯಾಕಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಸಿ ಎ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ನನಗೆ ಕಾಮರ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಯಾವುದೂ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ನನ್ನ ತಂದೆ ಒಬ್ರು ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಇದ್ರು, ಗಿರಿಧರ ಸರಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಉಡುಪಿ ಪೂರ್ಣಪ್ರಜ್ಞಾ ಕಾಲೇಜಿದ್ದು ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಾಲ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರು ಅವರು, ಕೆ ಜಿ ತಂತ್ರಿಗಳು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು. ಅವರು ಕಾಮರ್ಸ್ ಕಲಿತವರು. ನಾನು ಅವ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಹೋಗಿ ಅವ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪಾಠ ಹೇಳಿಕೊಂಡು ಅವ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಗೈಡೆನ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ. ಆ ರೀತಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಇದು ಈ ರೀತಿಯ ಒಂದು ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಅವರಿಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಹಾಕದೆ ಅವರು ಮುಂದೆ ಹೋಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟರೆ ಅವರು ನಿಜವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಮೇಲೆ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಸಿ ಎ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಏನಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಸಿ ಎ ಆದ ನಂತರ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅವರನ್ನು ಹಿಡಿಯೋರು ಯಾರು ಇರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅವರಿಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದಷ್ಟು ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿಗಳಿದೆ. ಇದು ಒಂದು ಈ ಒಂದು ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಷ್ಟರವರೆಗೆ ಅನ್ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ನ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಬರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಬೇರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ನೀವು ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರು ಅನ್ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇದೆ. ವೇರ್ ಎಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸಿ ಎ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಅನ್ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಆಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಸ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಈ ರೀತಿಯ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಅನ್ನು ನೀವು ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಹಾಕದೆ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಅವರೊಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಮಿತ್ರನಾಗಿದ್ದುಕೊಂಡು ನೀವು ಮುಂದೆ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು. ಆಗ ಅವರು ಖಂಡಿತ ಮೇಲೆ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ಇದಿಷ್ಟು ನಾನು ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಇಚ್ಛೆ ಪಡ್ತೇನೆ. ಇನ್ನೇನಾದ್ರೂ ಇದ್ರೆ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಹೇಳಿಕೊಂಡು ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಮಾಡು. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಕಿರಣ್.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಭಾರ್ಗವ್. ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ನೈಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಯುವರ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್. ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ವಿ ಲರ್ನ್ಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಯು. ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್, ಐ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ನೋ ದಿಸ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದೋಸ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಡನ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ. Here's a man who has done BSc, not just PUC, and then got into a CA course. So please don't think that because I did science in my PUC, I have a disadvantage. Nothing like that. You are at par. You can still do it very well. I'll now move on to another close friend of mine, Shivanand. I am hoping that he also will come out with a nice Sanskrit shloka. Over to you, Shiv. Let's hear it from you. Unmute, please. 1 minute. You have to unmute yourself.
Hello.
Hi. Yes.
First of all, let me thank Kiran and team for this very unique program organized for the students as well as the parents. Probably I am missing this program. If you had conducted it 1.5-2 years before, I would have been on the other side. Anyways, having said that, first of all, let me congratulate all the students and the parents who have opted for this course. This is a CA and very reputed course, which we all you know, but still I would like to again reiterate that it is a very reputed course, and as Bhargav has said, the plethora of opportunities are there. Again, I'll tell, there are no vacancy board for a chartered accountant. That is the brighter side of this course. And my other point I would like to emphasize, I would like to share how Giri and my predecessor Bhargav has said. In the same line, I would like to continue my talk for a couple of minutes, and then I would like to get more questions rather than I am boring them. Bhargav had rightly snatched the shloka from me actually. Praptetu shodashe varshe putram mitreti drishtaye. But I had actually done it in Krishna's case. When he has reached 16, after his completion of PU, from first PU onwards, he had a flair for the law. So that's why he prepared for the law, CLAT examination. He got through it and he got a good ranking also. He got selected for Gandhinagar school. Law school. But when he has appeared for the CPT exams, he cleared in one shot. And then he had an option whether to this way or that way. And Kiran knows him very well. He had a very, what you can say, clarity of thought what he needs to be. Then I sat with him and I tried to understand what he wants to be. Both are good courses in this world. Nothing is bad. Everything is good if you look at it in the right perspective. So then he said, I would like to be a chartered accountant, but I want to do law. Then he said, first let me become chartered accountant, then I'll pursue my law. The reason why I'm narrating my son's issue here is, for simple reason, you allow them to take decisions. You just help them to take decisions. Parents, as a parents, we need to just help them and guide them to just take their decision, whether they are right or wrong. Even if they are wrong also, you need to correct them. Correct in what way? Just to help them to take a decision, not that you impose your decision to them. If I had to impose my decision, I would have asked Krishna to become IAS officer. I had a dream to become an IAS officer then. For some reasons, I have not opted for it. Then I have opted for chartered accountancy as Bhargav and Giri sir has opted. During those days in Karkala where I hail from, not many opportunities were there. Then I have, having taken commerce, what is the next best? I wanted to be excel in my life. Whatever I do, I always do it for knowledge and passion. That is what my request for all the students. Whatever you do, do it with passion. When you do it with passion, probably you will excel in your life. You will definitely, success is byproduct of your hard work. Success is definitely byproduct of your hard work. When you put your heart and soul into whatever you do, whether it is the studies or otherwise, wherever you do, but put in your heart and soul into that. When you do it with passion, you will be 100% successful. And by coming back to our course, it is always a teaching day. It is a learning day. Each day is a learning day for us. It is not only for chartered accountants per se, it is for everybody. But why I am telling more for a chartered accountants is the syllabus what you are looking at. It is a very vast, very huge, very huge. And as a parent, what I have done to my child when he was preparing for CPT, I have let him prepare himself. I have not at any point of time, I have not intervened what you need to do, what you have to study, this study. No, it is his passion he has to pursue. That's what I asked him to do. But when it came to intermediate, he started studying. He was very meticulous in those studies. But when exams were coming closer and closer and closer, he was getting little disturbed because I have read everything, but I am not able to recall. Then it is our, as a parents, it is our duty to sit with them and counsel them. See, the CA syllabus is like that. You need to understand. It is not your 10th or PU examination where you have scored 90% or 100%. It is not the fact. In that particular exam, in that particular paper, you would have scored 100 marks in that in account. But it is not the case. What you need to understand is the basic concepts of your subject. Then you develop on your own. That is what I have asked him to do. And he has taken the same path. What I'm trying to impress upon the parents here is, don't enforce anything on your child. Don't enforce anything on your child. You just sit with them. If at all they need a helping hand, just guide them. You do not try to impose, you have to study like that. Each kid is a different. It is a unique. Every child is an unique child. The one person may be able to grasp the subject in 2 hours. The other person may not be able to do so. But it doesn't mean that one person is studying for 14 hours a day. My child also should study like that. No, it should not be the case. Don't compare your child. As Giri has rightly said, don't compare your child with any other child. So let them plan, let them study, but ensure that they will not get demotivated at any point of time. What I am trying to tell you is that in CA course, there will not be any motivation from outside. I always tell my students in my office all the time, whenever the students fail, they come to me, I have a counseling session for them and I sit with them, what is gone, where gone wrong and everything we discuss. But what I'm trying to impress upon them and all the students who are in this program, don't look at outside for any motivation. You should have 3 S. One is the self-study and the self-motivation and the self-confidence. If you have these three, you will be successful in CA examinations. And it is always, Sarvajna has told, Kelavam Vallavarinda Kaltu, Halavam Malpavarinda Kandu, Matta Halavam Swataha, Tane Maadi Tiliyanda Sarvajna. That is what we need to, as a CA students, we have to see. Something you have to study from others, something you have to see and learn, and rest of the things you only have to do it, and because you are the creator of your destiny. So you yourself have to do it. And with these words, I thank Kiran again. I would like to take questions if any things are there. Thank you, Kiran.
Thank you, Chef. That was indeed a very enlightening kind of a speech that you gave us. So many things that all the three speakers have covered. Allow me to sum up whatever they have said and give my own inputs also in this direction. And then I would invite you all to ask questions. You can start typing the questions in the chat, or you can also use the mic by raising the hand, showing that hand signal, and I will talk to you. Well, I would start with what Girisar had to tell us. Perfect thoughts which I already had in my mind, and I was so nice, the way he put it was so nice. Okay, we need to understand. First, we need to understand this child very clearly. And as he said, the key word is patience. Patience is the best answer. Patience will get you the results. Having faith in the child is very important for a parent. If you don't believe, because the child depends on your faith. Now you ask a three-year-old boy, if you watch a three-year-old boy or a girl, she'll climb a wall and she'll ask the mom, Amma harbauda, can I jump? If the mom says, yes, you can, they will blindly jump. What I'm trying to tell you is that for them, the parents' thoughts are very important. They may not tell it to you so openly, but if they think you believe, they also will believe. So you are the path. You must always tell them, I know you can do it. Comparing one child to the other is one of the biggest crimes that the parents do, especially in school level. I detest that. I mean, how could you compare? An apple grows on an apple tree, not a lemon tree. So please understand, both the fruits are different. Similarly, every child is different, as all the three speakers have told you. And yes, we are fortunate that we don't have that many distractions, as Giri said so nicely. I like that very much. We were pretty okay. We didn't have TV also, for that matter. So we had nothing else to do but study. But these days, there are so many possible distractions, and students fall for them. And it's a great challenge between them. Still, they are managing it. So I also congratulate the CA students for taking up this course. And what Giri said is true. Don't talk. If they say etiquette is don't ask woman her age, don't ask the man how much he earns, well, don't ask a CA student about his results, please. That's the third thing I would like to add. Bhargav sir said an important thing, don't force anything to your children. Let them do it by their choice. That is the most essential and fundamental thing. Because among the more unsuccessful students, the common reason is they never wanted to become a chartered accountant. They were here because they got lost initially. So if your child wants to do CA first, yes, go to a CA office, find out more about it. I know Giri sir, Bhargav and Shiv has discussed about it. But yes, give them enough knowledge. If you don't have the knowledge, take them to your friends who have the knowledge. Orientation in the beginning is very important, okay? Treating your son or a daughter as a friend is also essential. The days have gone. I used to be very scared of my dad. My dad used to scream. I was scared of him. My dad's dad was even more stricter. There the strictness was common. But now if I become strict, it is not going to give me any result. Now the world has changed. So we have to change accordingly. Treat them like your friend. Don't pressurize, don't compare. And as Bhargav said, create the right atmosphere in the house. That is in the hand of the parents. Okay. Let me also share in this matter. I have met a couple of parents who tell me, I don't pressurize my daughter or my son. Then I ask them, when the results come, what do you do? Because the results sometimes are failures. What do you do? Oh, I keep quiet. I don't tell anything. That is the problem. You keep quiet. Even silence is negative communication. In those moments, you should know how to handle it. Let them know you don't mind. You understand, as Bhargav said, it's a come again exam. When there is May, there is always a November. When there is November, there is always a May. Take it like that. Take it in your stride. You have to learn to show them how to deal with those little failures of life, because that is going to make you bigger persons. So don't think failure is negative. Failure helps us to get back. Failure gives us the energy, the momentum to spring back to success. So make them feel that. Believe in you, you can do it, are the words that they want. So I'm losing connection. I don't know why. Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible.
Okay, thank you. I'll continue. I can't see the screen. So we need to communicate. The basic essential is proper communication with the child. And like Giri said, when you communicate, don't sit with your mobile or don't keep the TV on, keep looking at the TV every now and then. Listen to them. Listen to them. Because it is only when we listen to them, what we do to them, you sow what you reap. If you listen to them now, when you get old, they will listen to you. Remember that. Communication is very, very important. I like the point of Shiv when he said, don't take their decisions. Learn, make them understand how to take the right decision. Give them all the factors, put them, organize those factors into options, the pros, the cons, and then let them see the wisdom, let them decide. It should always be their decision. Our job would be to be a friend, philosopher, guide to them. Show them the various options and then let them make that choice. And yes, it is not a UC exam. It is not a board exam. So conceptual understanding is the most important thing. So when you say, "Nodu maga, ninna pakkada maneyava 15 gante ottane, neenu 5 gante matra otta iddiya," doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense at all. There is no comparison of that sort at all. Okay? Because every student is unique. And those three words, the three terms that Shiv said, self-study, self-motivation, and self-confidence, are the three keys, one master key, I should say, to succeed. So parents, my addition finally would be, don't be a helicopter parent. What is this helicopter parent? These days, the parent has changed. They are always constantly surveying their child, and anytime the child falls, they're running there to pick him up also. Let the child learn to fall and get up by himself or herself. That is training. You be there behind their backs to make sure they are not getting hurt. That is training. Let them search for solutions of their own problems. It is but natural for them to come running, Amma, Appa, Anta. But help sit down with them. Make them realize that solution is something they have to search for themselves. Life ahead, we are not going to be there with them permanently. Let them learn to walk through the difficulties, the challenges of this life. We are friends, philosophers, guides. We are, as I call the seminar, a companion, a source of inspiration, a source of motivation, a source of guidance. Have faith in your child. he will definitely, he or she will definitely make it one day. So now we are inviting questions from parents. Please do ask questions. I don't want compliments. I'm getting compliments, but we want questions from you. And that's why I've called these three learned people, because they will be able to share their experience with you. So go on. Let's hear out some questions. Can I hear some questions? Anybody? This is an opportunity we have. Let's make use of the opportunity. Okay, can I ask a question to Giri sir? Considering the present situation, the circumstances, there are a lot of questions coming from my students. Sir, should I choose that opt out from the COVID attempt? August is an exam, but the institute has given them an option to opt out of the exam if they want to, and they can write in the next attempt. What would you suggest, sir?
It depends on how prepared you are. Okay, if you are preparing to take both the groups and you are 90% almost there, you better take it, because this will be like a net practice. Okay, but most of the mistake students make is, once they take an exam, they will wait till the results come. Okay, you take this as a mock test, doesn't matter, but take it as a mock test, then continue the studies. Then even if you lose, November you can go with more confidence and more preparation. So that is what I would have done if I were in their place.
Bhargava or Shiv, want to add something to this?
No, as Giri said, it is always, whatever opportunity is coming, the institute is giving you an opportunity to write the exam. Am I audible?
Yeah, very clear.
Yeah. So you take the exam. Whether you have prepared or not, at least you can see the question paper. If you are going for the first time, at least you can see the question paper. You will come to know how the exams are. So that will be a moral booster for you. If you succeed, it is well and good. Otherwise, for the next one, this will be a pedestal for you to go up. I think you should not miss this opportunity if you already given and if you have studied.
Let me add, because in every exam, we see some at least two or three marks card where they will get 200 in group one, 200 in group two, and pass both the groups. Okay, so this doesn't happen all the time. It may happen once in a lifetime to one person. So it may be your chance this time.
Yeah. Correct. Very true. Shiv, I have to ask you a question.
Yeah.
Is discipline important, like eating at the right time, sleeping for the right amount, you know? How important is discipline while studying? As a parent, what should I do to ensure that this is done?
As a parent, always we ensure that in the pressure to study more, in the pressure to cope up more, don't lose the focus on your health. So discipline is very much required. But when there is a need to study for a couple of days more, you can do it. You have to have the flexibility, but at the same time, you are not supposed to compromise on the discipline. Sleep you need to have, because everyone needs sleep, but how much? That is also matters. If you are passionate about the subject, no, then 2 hours, 3 hours sleep also sufficient. If it is a boring subject, you may need 8-10 hours also. Then also it is insufficient. What I'm trying to tell you is that discipline is very important. And when you are inching closer to the examinations, you need to have a sufficient sound sleep. And preparations always goes well with your good food habits and good sleeping habits. And I would like to add here, because 2-3 months students are studying, during that period when you are fixed to a particular chair and studying always, then your physical efficiency also is required to be improved upon. You need to do some meditation, need to do some exercises, so that your focus on the subject will be more penetrated. That's what I did for my son.
Very good. Yeah. Okay, here's the chat. I have some questions coming in the chat box. I'll read the first question. Vikram Shanoy, after the results, we come across tons of idiots who bring our morale down and demotivate us. At such time, how can we get out of this and gear up for the next attempt? Girimam, can you take this question, please?
Why don't pay any heed to them, no? See, if you see a test match, there will be 1,000 people sitting around and saying so many things, but you are concentrating on the wicket. So you have no business to get demotivated with that. So don't worry. Okay, so it should give you to come out with refreshed, vigor. Okay, because it's a challenge. They are challenging you. You have to take it up in right spirit. Don't worry about that. This has happened with all of us. We all have come through the same route. We all have heard it 101 times. Okay, so it's happening to you. So don't worry. You'll be strong. Every time someone throws some filth at you, you'll come out stronger. Don't worry about that. You can take it up more, because once you come to practice, there may be one cranky ITO or one GST officer who is of cantankerous character. Then you will know, I have come out of all this before. I don't worry. This is what you have to take.
Very true. Vikram, can I add? See, there are three kinds of intelligence we have. The moral quotient, the intelligence quotient, and the emotional quotient. Moral quotient, our parents, our surroundings, we have enough. The intelligence quotient, we are working on it. But we must pay attention to the emotional quotient. What triggers negativity in you? Why would somebody else's word trigger that? Your emotions, you are in control. So learn not to react. Take it as a challenge. The criticizers, the critics who are there, the people who give you bad comments, they are the biggest motivators, actually. So yes. Take them positively. They are your motivators. Listen to them more. Come on, tell me, what do you have to tell me? But I'm going to show you what I can do. That should be your answer in action, not in words immediately. Don't respond. Digest it. They are doing what they are doing because they have nothing else to do. But you have a right to react in the manner expected from you. Emotionally control yourself. Let's move on to another question that has come up in the chat box. Please give suggestions to students being pressurized to small talks more and socialize with relatives. This is very important. Bhargav, can you throw some light on this? Please give suggestions on students being pressurized to small talk more and socialize with relatives.
Small talk in the sense?
Small talk, even though the CM only got it, that's small talk.
Those times. Okay. Don't, you just listen it in one ear and leave it in the other ear. That's what.
Exactly.
That's what. Those things, it is there in every field. It is not only in CA or whatever it is. Whenever, and I think in our society, it is more. If you see somebody is doing something and the person who is talking thinks that what he is doing is not correct, he will go on talking like that only, small talks. So don't pay heed to him. You give him a smile, say hello, how are you? Keep quiet. God bless you. Go, move away. That's what.
Correct.
What is right?
About this socializing with relatives, Shiv, some of our CA students avoid relatives.
According to me,
wait, isn't it? So what is
that? Yeah. One should not avoid socializing. Why? Just because you have joined CA course, you are not supposed to cut off from the society. You are a part of the society. Why one should avoid? You get socialized so that you be with the society. At the same time, ensure that your focus is not too much diluted from your core studies. That's what we need to ensure. And I would like to add whatever Giri and this one has, Bhargav sir has told. When negative being talked about, small talks and other things, keep in mind, students, the same people will come back to you and congratulate you when you clear. Those are all the people come first to you and congratulate. So it is your duty to respond back in a bounce back as a sphinx when you fail. When you take the failure in a balanced way, failure and pass, that is one saying in Kannada, it goes like this. In gym, if you had the wrestlers, they fight, no? They would have practiced for years together, and they you would have lost in particular wrestling competition. But it doesn't mean that he has lost his all his practice. He would have built up his body very good, so that, as Giri has said, it is even after completion of your articleship, you are better than your peers. Don't compare with your peers. Don't compare with your peers. You have to compare in positive way. That is a one more thing I would like to add. Normally the students compare themselves to the other student. ಓ ನನ್ನ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ಮೇಟ್ ಅವನು ಈಗ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಸೇರಿ ಅವನಿಗೆ 25,000 ಸಂಬಳ ಉಂಟು, ನನಗೆ ಈಗ 3,000 ಮಾತ್ರ ಸ್ಟೈಪೆಂಡ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಡೋಂಟ್. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಚಾರ್ಟರ್ಡ್ ಅಕೌಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಅರ್ನ್ 1 lakh. ಸೊ ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಆನ್ ದೋಸ್ ಲೈನ್, ಬಿ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್. ಆಲ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನೋ, ಆಲ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಅಚೀವ್ ಯುವರ್ ಗೋಲ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಮೈ ಟೇಕ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಶಿವ. Here is a question which came to me in my private chat. I would like to keep that questioner anonymous as he requested. The question is, I'll just read it. It says, sometimes I feel pressure when parents do their part and myself doubt if I will make it. And hence there is no one to blame but me. It adds to the, okay. I think this is the first step. You know, one of the biggest aspects of positive attitude is taking responsibility. Now that you have identified that the blame is to be on me, that means you have taken the responsibility. Your attitude is just right for a student. That's how it should be. Nobody can, you can't blame anybody else. Stop blaming people. You can't blame parents. You can't blame the institute. You can't blame the teachers. If there's anybody to blame, it should be me. That should be your attitude, and you're the right task. Then one more person said about the previous small talk and pressures. Again, anonymously wants to say, it adds to the pressure of the introvert students. Most of my students are introverts. I don't deny that. But it will add to your pressure only if you allow it to be added. That control should be in your hands. What gives you pressure and what does not give you pressure? So please, you are the master of your emotions. Sharpen your emotional intelligence. Make it more powerful. Learn not to react. That is more important. One more question is coming. Sir, can you give me some tips to come out of the inferiority complex after facing the failures in a CA exam? Anyone could take this up? One of you? Can you give me some tips to come out of the inferiority complex? Yes, Bhargav, you're saying something.
Yeah. When why? Actually, I will narrate one incident when we were doing our articles. In Udupi, when the results came and our two or three of us, our friends had failed. And we were talking and one fellow was saying, oh, naan fail agidene, in yen madodu gottilla, like that and all. Nam hindugadendo obru elderly person was coming and he was listening to us, what we were talking. Avarna hudugana namma friend idu Ben Thatkarthu helidru. Huduga, failure is the ladder to success. He didn't know who we were. So don't, because in CA exam is one thing, it will teach you the lessons of life. It will teach you how to handle the failures. So handle the failures in a positive way. Make an attempt to the next this one. So it is all there. We also, it is not that I have passed everything in the first attempt. I have taken 2-3 attempts to pass. So these things are there. Definitely that will add you and that will teach you how to come up in the life. So don't feel inferior, because joining CA course and giving exam itself is one big thing which you have taken a decision. So don't feel inferior to others. So it is there in the life. Yes.
Inferiority complex is a result of our thinking.
Yes.
Correct.
Correct.
So, please understand, people are not going to remember that you failed. They are going to remember how you reacted to the failure. That's what Bhargav Sir is trying to say. So if you take it as positive, it's fine. And one thing, let me define you. The CA course is not all and everything in life. Your life is more important. What you do, your actions will speak about you. Not your failures. Your actions after the failures will speak about you. So take it positive. Let's see, one more question has come in. Don't mind if I extend this session for some more time. Yes. The questions are coming. I don't want to stop their enthusiasm. Okay. Very nice question. It's a private question again. Some parents pressurize by saying CA is a tough course and you need to focus only on books rather than entertainment and enjoyment. So is it true that a CA student studies for the whole day and says no to any such distractions?
Shall I tell you one incident?
Yeah, please.
When I was studying, whether the studies are over, whatever is the thing, if tomorrow is, usually it starts on the 1st of November or 2nd of May every year. So if it is 2nd of May, on 1st of November, I used to close all the books. I had one friend in Udupi, now he's practicing there. His house was near the beach. We used to go to the beach, have fun, sit in the beach till evening, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, then come back. So forget everything. So it will refresh you. Yeah. All your inferiority complex, all your negativity in the mind, all your doubts, everything will be there. So next day, when early morning, when you get up and you refresh, you will come to know that this, of course, this was to me. I don't think it may be for everyone. But don't think that only study. You should, in between, you should take time to recreation and other things. Then you will keep it, it will keep you in good state. That's what I feel.
So, and this,
very true, very true. Yes, Giri, you want to add something?
And this recreation or relaxation, whatever you call, it should not be a distraction.
Yes, correct.
Okay, it should not come back to you. You should not come back after that and come back home. And while reading, it should not be a distraction so that, take for example, you send one WhatsApp. Okay, you went with your old students of some school, you had a nice time, you came home. And then they chat on the WhatsApp, you are part of that, then definitely that whole night is gone. Okay. So it depends how you handle it.
So true, Giri. See, I would say you need to balance your life. All study makes Jack a dull boy. But the distraction should be more positive. Like I would say, go and play football, play cricket. You should sweat for at least 1 hour or half an hour. Then you come back and study, see the change. That would be a entertainment. Doing some physical exercise. Do some gardening. Help your mom in the kitchen. Why not? That would be help. That would be nice. That could be instruction. But avoid screens. Whether it's a TV screen, mobile screen, computer screen, laptop screen, tab screens. That you should minimize because that hurts. Now, of course, I can't tell you because I teach over the net. So now I have to take back my own words. But minimize your unnecessary screen distraction.
This is a good screen.
Yeah.
Since we have parents in this forum, let me just address this to parents. So allow your children to grow. So let them have some hobbies. Let them start some hobbies. And if they already have some hobbies, encourage them to pursue those hobbies. So this will help them, though not maybe it may seem at the time of examination, it's a distraction and all that. Temporarily, they can come out of that. But once they finish CA, it would be a great asset to them because they can always fall back upon. Each of us sitting here in this panel have so many hobbies. Okay, and we are really happy that we have developed those hobbies. So yes. You always have to do that. And one more thing I wanted to say in such a forum is, today, the way children are brought up, especially if you have one child at home, you don't want him or her to fail. Okay, so you don't mind going to the principal or teacher for one mark, sitting outside his room for 2 hours to get one mark more so that she is better than her cousin. Okay, never do this. Stop it at 10th standard. Don't bring this to CA. If they don't know how to handle failure, they'll be a failure in life. So CA teaches that. So I'm telling this out of my experience. One of my hobbies is flying kites. So we go to various schools holding kite making camps. So it is very strange to see students of 6th, 7th, 8th standard standing in the queue to instead of we teach them how to tie a knot to the kite, that kite line. Okay, instead of trying that, they don't mind waiting for 2 hours for the instructor to tie it because they don't want their kite to fail. So fear of failure is always there in today's generation students. So this has to be brought out of their mind. If you have a single child and throughout he is a topper in the class and he wants to come for CA, you have to somehow teach him that failure is part of life and take and remember these failures will make you strong. We can watch for this today. Maybe in our 20s, we too were in the same stage, but today we can watch for that. All these failures which we have faced in our life has definitely made us stronger.
Thank you, Giri. That's so beautiful.
And another thing I would like to add what Giri has said. As a parent, we should not express our expectation in front of our children.
True.
We should not express our expectations.
Very true.
We should teach them, see, failure, you have to put in your best work. The success and failure, you leave it to the Lord. I'm sounding a little philosophical, but it is not so. When you take both the good and bad in the same spirit, then your kid will be able to take it in the right spirit. That's what I would like to add. Yeah.
Absolutely true. Absolutely true. Here's another serious question. Again, anonymous. I'm not going to read the name of the person. Keep me anonymous is the first words he's used. Sir, my parents tell me that I should clear my CA foundation in first attempt. And they keep asking. It demotivates me somehow. And when I ask them, what if I fail? They never told me about it, where I get pressurized. My dad keeps asking me about my syllabus. And when I say I haven't completed, he gets annoyed. Please. Somebody tell them, tell these parents what is to be done. Giri.
I think I've already covered it, but still let me tell them. CA is one such course where you take 10 papers of last 10 attempts. The 11th paper will be different. So it all depends on what your child does in those 3 hours on that particular day in the examination hall. So leave it to him and always take it as even if he fails, it is for his own good because destiny has something in for him and there is a way to attain that. And these are all hard ways to attain that. Take it that way and leave it to him. He will come out. Don't worry about that.
Yes, Giri. Unfortunately, that parent may not be listening to us. Okay, because this boy's parent particularly. Yeah. I have a message for you. You are not 15, 16 anymore. You are 18 plus. You must learn to stand up for yourself. I'm not asking you to argue with your parents or fight with your parents, but tell your position very clearly. I am doing what is expected of me in the best way possible. And like Giri sir said, results, I will leave it. Or like Shivanand said, leave it to the Lord. Be philosophical. But you assure your parents, look, I am doing my best and I don't want you to keep reminding me of that. Learn to say it. Then they will start having faith in you. All you want to do is me to pass and become a CA. I will do that. You leave it to me. But you're constantly telling me is hurting me. That you should tell them. If you don't make them realize, they will continue what they do. And you will continue to suffer. There is no end to this problem. Somewhere, you need to assert yourself. Assertive skills are important for everybody. You learn to stand up to such negativity because they don't know. Why are they pressurizing you? Because they love you. Let's not forget that. They love you too much. So you have to tell them, look, I understand your love for me, your concern for me, but this is my position. I may not clear in the first shot and I don't give a big deal about passing or failing. What I give a big deal is giving my best to the attempt without thinking of all this. That is what is required of me. This is my message to you. Okay. One more question has come up. Do you think this opt-out option given is an advantage for those who opted only one group as they thought this cares of time and how stuck with this unexpected pandemic? I'm not too sure of what it actually means. If you can read the chat box and see that question and answer one of you, please. I think I asked this question earlier. Should we take that opt-out option or not? Oh, it's come to me privately. I don't think you can read it.
Yeah.
I'll read again. Do you think this opt-out option given is an advantage for those students who opted only one group, as they thought of, as the thought of time, the scares of time, how stuck with is this unexpected pandemic. So what she's basically trying to ask me is, should I go for the option of opt-out because I have chosen only for one group? There is no certainty about the next examination also. What should I do?
Yeah, no, if you are pretty sure that you want to go for, take both the groups next time, and you are prepared for that, then you can opt out. Otherwise, you take the exam. Because many of the, I know many of the articles from our own office who take 4 months leave. Then at the end of the day, after the examination, when they come back, sir, time sakagalilla, preparation sakagalilla, one day group ikkutkonda. So this happens with most of the students. So if you are ready to take it up, if it is you are just postponing the D-Day, then this is not the way. If you are ready to take up both the groups, then you can do that. Otherwise, you sit for one group and then you attempt for the next with both the groups.
If at all your preparations are pretty good for first group, go ahead and attempt it.
Yeah.
If you are so-so and you would like to attempt both the groups, then you do it. And another thing I would like to tell most of the students, that what they do mistake is take good amount of leave, 3, 4, 5 months and all. Then initial date, that momentum is not there for study. They do not plan it well. And at the end of the day, so no, this is not possible now. It is not so. So then they get into the pressure and they quit. That should not be the case. Always the students, the lesser the amount of leave you take, the pressure will be there on you, but the delivery will be the better. Always. That is what my experience in last 25 years, I have seen the students, those people are doing that. The more number of leave they take, the failures are more. That's what my reading. Because they don't plan it well. That's what I'm trying to say. If you take 6 months leave, no problem. Attempt for both the groups. Have 3 times revision, not 2, 3 times revision. That kind of a planning you should have. Then only you can attempt. Otherwise, what happens? Once reading and otherwise revision means you will have a play, that is a, what you call problems of plenty. You have enough and more leave. That is what it is.
Like if you notice in the match when the asking rates gets higher, the team performance also gets better.
Better.
Going example, you see?
Yeah.
So, very true. You should make sure they use the time, you know, very well.
And another problem normally the student faces is more number of leave you take, then probably that inertia and lethargy will creep in normally. Then you need to identify what is your strength and what is your weakness. What is that one particular thing makes you motivated to study more? That is what you have to read. I'll give you an example of my own. My home is a remote place in Karkala, wherein we didn't have the traveling vehicle or whatever. I had only cycle. So even I had taken for 20 days leave, I knew this is not sufficient, but I need to get pressure and then I have to read. What I used to do is early morning, the theory subject I have to read, no? I used to take cycle, go to Karkal for a matinee show, view a movie, whatever it is, you see there. End of the movie, you come back, again back 5 kilometers. Then you will say, oh, whole day is lost. Then full night out and next day full. Your subject is clear. That's what I have identified. What is that was motivating me to read more. So that is what I used to do. But if it is only movie, then I would have lost.
Yeah, actually, you have a key there. Self-awareness is so important.
Yeah, important.
Be aware of what you react. Correct.
Very correct. You need to identify your strengths.
Yes.
Kiran, there is one question which has come, or not question. Thank you for this session, for an opportunity to spend time with my child.
Beautiful.
This is very, very important because most of us in during our childhood, there was a huge gap between us and our parents. We never used to talk to them like we talk to our children. So in many cases, the parents take the same gene with them. So they have the same gap with their children when it comes to dealing with them. So this has to be avoided. How to repair that, you have to formulate your own solution for that. So how I did was when my child was in the elementary schools, we started Bachcha Party, where lot of children used to have camps during summer camp, 10 days camp. My child was part of it. So what I wanted to teach her, I used to teach
these
50 people. Okay, then I started cycling with them. Yeah. Then cycling again, I started with my family. Four of us started going. Then our neighbors came. Then it became so huge that just 3 years back, it crossed 3,000 people, most of them students. So this is how I could teach them the discipline of riding. Then I take them to trekking regularly. So one motivation that I gave to her during her PUC was, if you get good marks, I'm going to send you for Himalayan trekking. Imagine, after PUC, lone girl with one more group, none of us were there in the group. I sent her alone to Himachal Pradesh for Himalayan trek for 10 days. So because we have to build up them, we have to build courage in these students, because they are not going to be in Mangalore tomorrow. Once they qualify, they will have to compete with people. And when it comes to competing, I should not say this, but there are people who come from other side of this country who are much more dominating than what we are from here. So we have to handle they have to handle such people. So they have to be strong. And the only way they can be strong is from their childhood days. So we have to keep this in mind. And when you do all this, then naturally you will be with them and you will be part of their close circle, and they will confide in you whatever they want to say. So this we have to develop, this culture. If we don't develop, it will be very difficult. There will be a gap, and there we have to find some via media person who will talk to them. Kiran must be having 101 examples of such things.
Right, sir. Right, Giri. I have another question that has come. I would like to answer that question. It is again an anonymous question. I'll read it as it is. Keep me anonymous. My mom always tells I don't put much efforts. But the thing is, when I study or listen, I concentrate during that time and recall wherever I feel and when I'm at leisure. The problem is I don't spend a lot of time studying, and she thinks I don't put efforts. And in brackets, and she is listening to the meeting, sir. To that mother, congratulations for your concern over your parent. But I'm sure you are not a CA student and you do not know what is there in the CA subjects. Have faith in your daughter. I know her personally. She's a very good student. We need to have faith. I know your concern. You keep reminding her that you should study. Don't make it too often, because those words become valueless afterwards. You keep repeating that command, vodu, vodu, pado, pado, study, study. After some time, it has no value. They think it is a recorded voice that is coming from a machine. So use it very wisely. Okay? Use it very wisely and have faith. And the student also should express to the mom, I am putting in the efforts. I am confident. If you keep going to your mom and say, Mom, I am getting worried, tomorrow is my exam, what I will do, will I pass or not? That is not the way to react with your parents. You should control your emotions first. I am in a position to do this. I have grown up. I will face this. That is more important. Here's one more question. I'm going to appear intermediate exam in November. So when can I expect the exam? Oh, sorry. We are not astrologers here. We have the same query that you have. So I cannot answer your question. But remember one thing. You think that the exam is tomorrow and study today.
Correct.
Please, that is important. You study today. Tomorrow the exam. You keep studying. Because, and one more thing, try not to study for an exam. Study for life. It is going to be useful somewhere or the other. So keep studying. We have come to 7:19, time that we have really exceeded far and beyond. I don't know if my panel won't mind, but if there is any one last question, I'll stop with that. Otherwise, if there's no question, I would like to stop, because it's already 7:20 now. Anybody wants to ask any question quickly? I'm sure you have enjoyed this session thoroughly. I'm so glad that I asked three friends of mine to come in. And what I have been able to achieve today is because of them. And I got much, much more than what I expected also. So I'm really, from the bottom of my heart, I am thankful to them. I call them because I know that they are concerned about the students. I know that they are genuine chartered accountants who are interested in the progress of other students also. And that's why I call them, and our purpose is highly served. Thank you, Giri.
Yeah,
thank you, Bhargav. Thank you,
thank you, thank you. Thank you.
A great evening.
Thank you.
One question has come, so sorry. Last question. Sir, is it possible to prepare for both the groups for November attempt because the second group coaching is yet to start? The answer to that question lies with you. If you think it is possible, it is possible. If you think it is not possible, it is not possible. Go up, look into the mirror and ask this question. If you want to ask me the question, anything is possible when I decide it is possible. With that note, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for your time. Thank you, participants. Thank you, panelists. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, and all the best to all the parents.
Yeah.
And students.
Thank you. All the best.
All the best to the students.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.